गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ न्यू टॉपिक. टॉपिक नेम इज हफमन ट्री. नाउ बिफोर वी टेक अप वन एग्जाम्पल एंड ट्रेस इट, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई दिस टॉपिक इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. दिस टॉपिक इज अ टेक्निक ऑफ एनकोडिंग द कैरेक्टर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कैपिटल ए, ASCII वैल्यू इज 65. नाउ ए इज एनकोडेड एज 65, कैपिटल बी इज एनकोडेड एज 66. Meaning is computer understands A as 65, not as A. Okay, so each and every characters that appear on the keyboard are encoded to a different values, right? So ASCII is one way of encoding the characters. Just like that, we may come across an instance where I want to send a message from source to destination, where only destination person should read it. No other person should read it in between. For that, what we can do is we can encode the message, send it. At the receiver side, they can decode and see that. Clear? So there are different techniques of encoding, like fixed length encoding, variable length encoding. Just like every other encoding technique, Huffman tree is also encoding technique, which was introduced by David Huffman. Now let us take this example. Characters are given A, B, C, D and hyphen. The probabilities are also given 0.35, 0.1, 0.2, 0.2, 0.15. We need to find a code word of each and every character. Now these code words will be used for encoding the characters, right? Now to find code word, we have to generate a Huffman tree. Now that tree is going to tell us what is a code word for A, what is a code word for B, code word for C, code word for D, right? So directly we will solve this problem and try to understand what is a code word for each and every character. Now if you want to solve this, the first thing we do is we scan all the probabilities and assign each and every character and their probabilities in increasing order of their probabilities. So I take B first. The probability of B is 0.1. Next, we take hyphen, probability is 0.15. Okay. Next, I take C, probability is 0.2. Next is D, probability is 0.2. Right. Last one is A, probability is 0.35. The first thing we do is, according to their increasing order of probability, we have to align them. Okay. Now just go on building subtree from left to right. I club these two to generate a subtree. These two to generate a subtree. Right. So I just join these two. I get B 0.1 hyphen 0.15. Both of them, we add both the probabilities to generate a node, we get 0.25. Okay, right? Now similarly, merge these two, you get C 0.2, D 0.2. Merge both of them, you get 0.4. Okay. Now see, we have merged first two, next two we got subtrees. There is one more character remaining whose probability is 0.35. Now we need to merge it again with some subtree. Where we have to merge it now? If you compare 0.25 and 0.4, this value lies in between. So I bring that here. A value is 0.35. Okay? Right? Now what I am going to do is, I am going to merge these two values. Once you merge these two values, what is the answer you get? You see 0.25 and 0.35. If you add it, you get a value called 6. Right? So we get 0.6. Left side we have 0.25. Left side of that is B, whose probability is 0.1. okay. Right side is we have hyphen probability as 0.15, okay, right. Now right side of that we have A, okay. What is the probability of A now? It is 0.35. Clear? So we got, what we have done is we have merged this and this, we got a subtree, okay. Now the next thing we have to do is we have to merge this one with a remaining subtree. What is the value of that? It is 0.4. Now the value of this is 0.6. I take this left side, 0.4, okay. Left one is C with a value 0.2, right one is D with a value 0.2, okay, right. Now add these two values, you get 1.0. You can see here, we got a Huffman tree. What we have done is, from left to right we have to merge the values. We merged it like this. Next two values are merged to get 0.4. Now this value is remaining 0.35, it lies between these two. From left to right we have to merge. We have clubbed this and this node. We got this subtree 0.6. Okay. Now this 0.6 is merged with 0.4. We got this one. Okay. Now this is a final Huffman tree we got. Now once we generate final Huffman tree, what we have to do is we have to assign the codes for left child and right child. Left child we assign 0 and right child we assign 1. Okay. So since this is a right child, I make it 1. This is also 1. This is a left child, I make it 0 and 0, and this is 1. Okay. So once Huffman tree is built, what we do is we assign 0 to left child and assign 1 to right child. Now let us see what is a code word of A. Where A comes? A comes here. Now from root node you have to trace it. This is 1, from here it is 1. So the code word of A is 1 and 1. What is the code word of B? Where is B? B is here. Trace the value of B from the root. This is 1, 0, 0. So I got 1, 0, 0. What is the value for C? C is here, 0 and 0. D is 0, 1. Okay, D is 0 and 1. And what about hyphen? Hyphen is here, 1, 0, 1. It is 1, 0, 1. Clear? Now, once you calculate code word, they may ask you to generate a code word for a sequence. Let us say, CAD. What is the encoding character for CAD now? You take value, a code word for C. What is the code word for C? 0, 0. Code word for A is 1, 1. Code word for D, it is 0, 1. This is a encoding code word. I mean, this is a code word for word CAD. This is how we have to do it. Okay. So this is one thing. Now, they may ask you to define what is a bit length for this entire thing. Bit length for this entire thing. How to do that is, take A. How many characters are there for A? It is only 2. What is the probability of A? It is 0.35. Take how many characters are there to encode B? It is 3. What is the probability of B? It is 0.1. Plus, now for C, how many characters are there? For the encoding characters are 2. What is the probability of that? It is 0.2. Similarly, for D, 2 characters, probability of that is 0.2. Similarly, for hyphen, it is how many characters are there for encoding? How many bits? 3. What is the probability of that? 0.2. Okay? You add up all of them. If you add all of them, you get something around 2.25. Now, what is the meaning of this? It is like, for this Huffman tree, on an average, 2.25 bits are used to encode each and every character. Okay? So, this is a topic where in exam they may ask you to define what is Huffman tree. They will give a character's probability, they will ask you to find a code word. And then they may ask what is a code word for cat, for car, for school,
for college like that,
right? Otherwise they may ask you to tell what is the average bit length used for this command. Okay, this is one example where a problem will be given, you need to solve it. Thank you.